In today's video, I'm going to create a base application with React.js support using Adobe's archetype, create an AEM component using React.js, and finally add the component into the page. Hi, I am Manuel Gutierrez from thelighthouse.co, and I make videos that help you learn about different programming topics like AEM, Docker, TensorFlow, Unity, and more. So, if you're new here, hit the subscribe and the bell notification buttons below so that you don't miss a thing. So, let's start! It is really simple to create an AEM app using Adobe's archetype, which by the time of this recording is on its 22nd release. You will need AEM 6.4 Service Pack 2 or newer for this video. I am going to use AEM 6.5. Now, for being able to create an app that supports React.js, we need at least the 23rd version, which is not out yet. So, if this is your case, there is a simple way to solve this. First, either clone or download Adobe's archetype so that you have a local version of it, change into the new directory and build the archetype. Until the 22nd version of the archetype, you had a way to create a module that uses Node.js by specifying option include frontend module equals true property on the archetype. Starting from the 23rd version, the property was changed to option frontend module, and its possible values are now none by default for omitting completely the Node.js module, general for a simple Node.js Maven module, Angular and React. So let's create the app from scratch. I am providing the most important properties in a single line here, given that the other properties will be inferred from them. Notice that the version that I'm using is the 23rd snapshot, and the option frontend module was set to React. After that, the archetype creates a folder called UI.frontend for our React application. I am going to focus on the src/components folder where all the components are located. Let's build and deploy our new app. Make sure that you have AEM up and running. For creating an AEM component using React, we need at least four things. A skeleton AEM component with a dialog, a React component, an entry importing the component inside the import components.js file, and a sling model, which I'll be configuring in the next video. I am going to use the Yeoman generator for creating the skeleton AEM component for me, with some additional example fields in the dialog. I am calling it basic component, and I am making sure that the names for the folders and component group match my current application's configuration. We should end up with a component inside react-simple-example/components called basic component. If you check the dialog's XML file, you will find two example fields, one for the text and another for the checkbox. Given that we are using React for this component, we will ignore the HTML script. For the React component, let's create a new folder inside components called basic component, and inside it, let's create an index.js file. Add the imports for the React.js library and map to helper from Adobe. Create an editconfig object, which will be used for displaying some text when the component is empty. In this case, given that the component's property, like the ones defined on the dialogues, are available through React's props object, we can just check if the props.txt doesn't have a value so that we can mark this component as empty. Then we have the component, which looks like a typical React component with its render method. Here, we can output the values for the text and checkbox properties inside the props object. Finally, we call the map2helper function that maps the React component to a particular resource type inside AEM, so that AEM knows which React component to use when rendering our page. Then, inside the import-components.js file, we import the basic component. Build and deploy the application again. Open the homepage for your new React simple example site inside AEM. If you don't see the basic component in the list, go to Templates and edit the one called React Page Template. Click on the Layout container and then on Policy. Scroll down and select the React Simple Example Content group. Then go back up, duplicate the policy, and click on Save. Go back to your page and refresh. You should be able to see the basic component now. Add the component into the page and some text. Check the checkbox and click on Save. Finally, refresh the page to see the changes. In the next video, we will be configuring the Sling model also so that we no longer have to refresh the page per each edition. Awesome! Congratulations and thanks for watching! And if you liked the video, please hit subscribe.